Tell them I'm ready, I'm ready for war. I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm ready, I'm ready. I'm ready for more. Whole squad in the field, yeah, we ready. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war. If you looking for me, you know where to find me. I leave you dusted, I leave you behind me. I flip the switch from 0 to 90. If you do too much, I'ma do the almighty. You know I got it, you know I'm a legend. You know I'm the one, I do not come in second. Please do not tempt me, don't hold it against me. We about that action, don't ever forget it. Squad of gorillas, the army, the navy. When I call a play, I'ma score like I'm Brady. The title is mine, if you want it, come take it. I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war. I'm ready for more. Tell them I'm ready for more. I'm ready for war. Tell them I'm ready for war.
So it's not nice.
Oh no, oh man, I just made a mess. When I run it, ain't no stopping, I'll never rest. Down said hunt, kick a punt, then I make a catch. 5,000 ones in an hour, I'ma make it stretch. I just made a mess, I just made a mess. I got cash by the bundle, so I'll never press. I just made a mess, I just made a mess. 50-yard TD with the winning catch. Oh no.
Chopped no Michael Watts. When I was 10, I knew I should have been on rap a lot. Think like Jay Prince. Prince, and I do more than just rap a lot.
Listen,
I went and got my digits up.
Listen,
your favorite, bruh.
Listen,
you don't want no trouble, cuz the 25th, I got a meeting with the governor. That's real rap a lot, no cap a lot. I used to from Farron down to Camelot. I used to whip a in my granny's pot. She asked my friends, was I? They said, no, be not. The mind to a praying woman. The truth's a heavy burden and it's weighing on me. Red dog has caught me slipping with the wailing on me. I went to calling out for Jesus like a reverend, homie. Chalked it up to sin, took it on my chin. Gotta take some L's if you wanna win. They took a, but then take a sin. I didn't even have no re-up I could re-up with. Had to rob another just to re-up.
Just a spectacular afternoon for football here in the Tar Heel State of North Carolina as EA Sports welcomes you inside Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Just a moment ago, the lights, the cameras, the action, all the pyrotechnics, everything was ablaze, everything was allowed here in Bank of America Stadium as Carolina emerged from their tunnel. And we are ready to go as the Panthers get set to match up with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. A nice little gift there to start the ball game as they will be.
I just made a mess. When they throw the pass, all I know is catch. I just want the bag. bag, like a Nike check. All I know is flex. Bust the defense open, running through some. I don't know no plays on the field, I just free from. Caught it with the left, but I'm better with my right arm. When they call blitz, hit stick, don't mean no harm. Oh no, oh man, I just made a mess. When I run it, ain't no stopping, I don't never rest. Down say a hunt, kick a punt, then I make them catch. 5,000 ones in an hour, I'ma make it stretch. I just made a mess, I just made a mess. I got cash by the bundle, so I'll never press.
Just a spectacular afternoon for football here in the Tar Heel State of North Carolina as EA Sports welcomes you inside Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Just a few moments ago, this building was shaking as the Carolina Panthers emerge from the tunnel here in Charlotte. They are ready to go as the Panthers are set to match up with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Lurching closer toward the midway point of this NFL.
Spectacular afternoon for football here in the Tar Heel State of North Carolina as EA Sports welcomes you inside Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Just a moment ago, the lights, the cameras, the action, all the pyrotechnics, everything was ablaze, everything was allowed here in Bank of America Stadium as Carolina emerged from their tunnel. And we are ready to go as the Panthers get set to match up with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. And no chance to get away as they get him down at about the 17-yard line. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. First carry for Christian McCaffrey. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line.
Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy is setting the tone early, running through all types of tackles and putting the defense back on its heels.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Now a run with McCaffrey. And he went backwards.
He'll be down at the 30. Looking at a second and 11 now after the loss. Off the play fake. Here's Wilson.
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted.
Picked off near the 29. And they will take over at the 29-yard line. So far this season, this defense has had their issues against the pass, so that's a great sign for them to get the early pick.
Yeah, confidence builder for them and an absolute shock for the quarterback because he went into it. He saw the numbers we saw. He watched them on tape. I think he came into this one thinking this is going to be a big day, and it very well could be, but early in this one, advantage defense.
First carry for the former Buckeye, J.K. Dobbins. Shrugs the tackle.
Nice.
7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three. Well, this defense for the Panthers, they played extremely well last week in the win over Atlanta.
I have to admit, I was extremely impressed by what I saw on tape because they stayed in the face of the quarterback the entire game, ended up getting 4 sacks total, and made it difficult for him to step up and find receivers downfield. Also made it hard for him to escape the pocket and run.
And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of 2, 3rd and 1. That's complete to his receiver, Godwin. The completion there winds up a wash, and it'll bring up 4th down.
Excuse my snarkiness here, but isn't the idea of completing a pass supposed to mean you get downfield and gain yards?
Especially on 3rd down.
Yeah, that one. How about the defense? Figured that one out in a big way. Yeah, they completed it all right and lost yardage.
Succop's kick is good. And the Bucs take a 3-0 lead. In the end, the opening drive, Charles, does yield points. Maybe not the touchdown that they wanted, though.
Yeah, but bottom line, they wanted to get something out of that drive, and they did that. 3 points, they won't turn that down at all.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, only gave up 3 points off of that, so shouldn't be a difficult hole to overcome.
It really shouldn't, as long as they're not listening to the chatter coming from the other side, because when you throw a pick, look, I know defensive backs, they have a tendency to be a little bit loud after they take one away, but they also have a tendency to gamble a little bit more, thinking they'll get a second one. Maybe they can take advantage of that with some double moves.
2nd and 6. Play action. It's Wilson. Being chased out left. And he wisely will throw that one away.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high power, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20, because to me that's the magic number. 20 points scored gives yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
He gets it left side to Johnson, and they're going to get him down well short of the first, as he can only get this to the 30. Good defense holds him to only a yard, and it'll be 4th down. Joseph Charlton and the punt team on now for the Panthers. Back deep, Jakeem Grant. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. A 45-yard punt, 4 there on the return, and the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they are trying to create some separation within the division. And look, CD, I know that this is still the first half of the season, but this is a big matchup no matter where it falls, because these are the top 2 teams right now in that division.
And if you can build a bit of a cushion as you head towards the second part of the season, that allows you to survive the expected injuries, potential upset losses, all of those things, and still be in good shape.
Here's second and a yard. Here's a give to Dobbins. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Brady looking to throw on third and two. This is a diving effort by Evans. What a catch.
When you're a player of his stature, you don't just circle the games on your team's calendar.
Circle the Pro Bowl?
Without a doubt. That's a game that you just figure you're going to be in each and every year. And it's because of catches like that. That's why he goes.
On play action. Now Brady. The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down. Hassan Reddick, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year. Second and 21, a lot of ground to cover. Now a handoff for Dobbins. And he'll be taken down, as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. 3-0 after one on EA Sports. The Panthers turn to their nickel set. Here is Higgin ready for third down. Brady now to throw. This is caught by Evans. And he'll be touched down here, but not before he does pick up the first. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
They'll run on first down. Grant. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. Oh, not sure he saw the linebacker there, as that's batted down and incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
They'll look to make it 3-for-3 on third down conversions. They need a yard here. They'll try to run for it with Dobbins. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. They had to settle for 3 last drive, hoping this second go around ends in 6. In good position, 1st and 10. Now a carry for Dobbins. And not much. Maybe a yard down to the 23. These two teams, they met in Tampa earlier in the year with the Bucs prevailing in that one. So a win here in Charlotte would give them the season sweep. Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run. Throwing now is Brady. He finds his target. It's Evans. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And they'll be faced with a 3rd and inches.
whistles here before the snap. Looked like one of the Bucks may have moved. The Bucks on third down. They've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5. Here's Brady to throw. And this is caught. Touchdown. Wait, hold a second here. A flag down. Let's see if this will stand. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. This will be a 37-yard attempt. And Succop will put this one right through. And they're able to double their lead in this first half. It's 6-0. So scores on their first two possessions, but 6-0. So field goal is probably not what they were hoping for.
Yeah, you're exactly right about that. Not what they were hoping for, but they should be happy that they have points on the board. It almost feels like that old slow and steady wins the race, doesn't it? In this case, though, they want to be slow and steady now, but get explosive later and put the points up on the board.
They go play action with Wilson. And he overshot him there. It's out of bounds, incomplete.
These two teams met up earlier in the year back in week 4, and it was the visitors getting the win there, so they'll be looking for the sweep back here at home.
So the incompletion, and now it's 2nd and 10, again from the 25-yard line. Wilson. He's going to air one out. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's 3rd down.
And he's only hit on 2 of his first 6 passes. Time for a quick quarterback regroup here with a big 3rd down coming up.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a 3rd and 10. Now it's Wilson. Flush to his right. Trying to fit it into Moore, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Jamel Dean. And he's able to get it back to right around the 27. I know it appeared he was saying, hey, give me the football, I'm open, but I don't know if that's a pass that he should have thrown there.
Well, I don't think we've ever met a wide receiver that doesn't think he is open or is about to be open.
True.
So when you throw your hand up in the air and tell your quarterback, hey, I'm available, he's trusting that you are. In this case, he was not, and it turned into disaster for them.
On 1st and 10, it's Dobbins. A beautiful fake. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. 2nd and 6.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
Play action. Now it's Brady. They'll roll him out right. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a 3rd down.
Well, the pressure just couldn't get to him that time. They forced him out to his right, but he held his poise, surveyed the field, didn't find anything he liked, and then took off and picked up a nice gain.
And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. It's Brady. And he's got a man. It's the tight end Howard complete. And he is going to have a Bucs first down as they're able to move the sticks with a gain of 4 on 3rd and inches. Now whistles here before the snap. Looked like one of the Bucs may have moved. False start backs him up 5. 1st and 15. Working from the gun, it's Brady. Steps away to his left. And that nearly intercepted. Oh, the free safety roaming into position almost had it, but it's 2nd down. Behind the sticks here with a 2nd and 15. This is Grant. And he'll take it from the 18 to the 15. A gain of 3. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. A 3rd field goal of the first half. Not what they're looking for as they come up on 3rd down. Now Brady. And he's got his tight end Howard. It's a Buccaneer touchdown. O.J. Howard, his 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Buccaneers here finding a way to stretch their lead. Extra point up and good by Succop. And the lead now stands at 13. Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough.
And Wilson's going to be intercepted a 3rd time. Picked up by Sean Murphy Bunting. And the Buccaneers are going to take over a couple of yards shy of midfield. 2nd straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one? Or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
They'll start on the ground with Dobbins. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. 2nd down.
Yeah, that wasn't a big run, just a short one there. But guess what? Sometimes you treat it like boxing. You throw that jab out there, and you throw it again, and you throw it again. Then you come with a big punch later. Maybe they're just trying to set him up.
The last run got a couple here, 2nd and 8. Brady. That's complete. It's Devin Duvernay. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. on first down. It's Grant. And he's taken down inside the 30.
Partner, if you want more carries, I think we saw how you get them. Showed that he's got the fresh legs, and he picked up the first down on that run. Don't just ask for him. Show him that you're supposed to get the football.
And they'll burn the timeout with 5 seconds left. A chance to try to add 3 points before heading to the locker room. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get 3 before halftime. This one from 46 yards out. And his kick is good. Didn't hit it all that well, but he got enough on it to put it through. And that's going to make this a 16-0 ball game. So that one is his 3rd of the game. Now, if you're wondering, that's only halfway to his career high, as he once had 6 field goals.
Oh, Brandon, but 6? Let's hope we don't get that again, please. Okay, can we see a few touchdowns here and there?
That'd be nice. And they're just going to run it here up the middle. And they're able to get this one across the 35. So we have reached halftime here with the visiting Buccaneers out on top. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Coach, thanks very much. Fine work as always as we welcome you back for quarter number 3. The Bucs with a lead, and they'll get the football first as the second half is underway. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. Quick pass out to Miller. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
On second down, a run with Dobbins. And he'll be tackled at about the 35. 45 yards on the ground for him so far.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
Oh, it's a nickel set here defensively on 3rd and inches.
Still want to be prepared for a pass.
On 3rd down, Grant. He is going nowhere as he is enveloped behind the line. And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on 4th and a yard. They'll go for it. It's Brady. Eluding the pressure right. That'll be caught. It's the tight end, Howard. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Both sides were holding their breath there on that 4th down play, and the offense can breathe a sigh of relief.
And both knew exactly where the 1st down markers were. You know the defense is trying to guard those sticks and try and keep people in front. But somehow, some way, those guys found a way to pick it up.
So from Panther territory now, it's 1st and 10 at the 48-yard line. They'll run on 1st down. Dobbins. And he's corralled at the 40, but not before picking up 8. Decided to hand it off that time on the run-pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady gain.
8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. They'll go again with Dobbins. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Now whistles here before the snap. Looked like one of the Bucks may have moved. Start backs him up 5, first and 15. Now Brady on the bootleg. Ball hit as he throws there, incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down. Now Brady bounces forward on the jet sweep, and he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. This defense not fooled one bit on that touch pass.
And this has become one of those kind of in vogue plays, you know, kind of like the shuffle pass was a few years ago. This one never got off the ground, but you understand why a lot of teams are running it. These wide receivers, a lot of them, they run like running backs with the ball in their hands.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And this is caught by Evans.
And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Into the red zone, it's Brady. And incomplete, a drop there in the middle third of the field. That'll bring up second down.
It looked like they had something there, but I think that he was thinking about running with the football before he actually hauled it in, and that led to a big drop.
Second and 10.
Here's Grant. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5.
A lot to praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called, they are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Jakeem Grant, his fourth touchdown on the year.
And the Buccaneers take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead.
Extra point put through by Succop. And that pushes the lead up to 23. And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away.
And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. Now Wilson on first down. Escaping the pressure right. And he's got the hook up to Moore. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. Second and 6, just inside the 30. Play action. Now Wilson. Oh, the Buccaneer pressure too much. Down he goes. Third and long. It's Wilson. Throwing left side. It's complete. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And we're back now in Charlotte. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number four. On first down, Wilson. Flushed out right. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. Defensively, you said coming in earlier in the broadcast, the magic number was 20 points for you. That's what you thought they would have to hold this offense to, or less than that. And wow, they've done that in a big way, haven't they?
Not only have they done it, they put themselves in a great position to win this one because holding them down was paramount. If they could get it done.
And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. A big connection on that one. 31 yards. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Wilson will throw again. Here's Johnson with a reception. And he'll be out of bounds. A big play that time through the air. 33 yards.
At this stage, there's nothing left to do but to keep firing. And if you're a play caller, you may go off your sheet and use some things maybe you hadn't planned to in this game. Maybe that was one of them there that worked.
Looking left side, that's caught by Moore. Touchdown, Panthers! DJ Moore hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Panthers are finally into the end zone here in this fourth quarter. He'll buy some time right. And he's going to get into the end zone for two. And they're back within two scores. Down 15 now. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Taking it about the one. And he'll get it up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. Bucks offense set to begin their next possession. Now, there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
The last run got six, now second and four. Another run here with Dobbins. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. What a dimension this man brings to this defense. He had his mind set there that he was going to get in and make that tackle. He really flew to the football.
And sometimes all of your best laid plans of play design, your X's and O's, they can't always account for individual effort defensively. And this was one of those times. Just a terrific play to hustle over there and get the running back to the ground.
Clock running, under four to play now as they come up on first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave him with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Second and 11 now. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Miller. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done.
Partner, I like that they're staying aggressive on offense because, to me, this drive is what is known as a put-away drive. You score here, that might put this one to bed. I like the fact that they're playing with confidence and not playing with fear.
On first down, Dobbins. And some room to run now. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6.
109 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here.
Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the 5. They'll run with Dobbins. And this time they were ready for him as he's taken down at the line of scrimmage. And his defense here going to burn their second timeout. But you can also factor in another timeout that they'll get when the clock stops at the 2-minute warning. They come up here with another shot from the 6-yard line, and it's second and goal now. They will run with Grant, and he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. Give him right around 4 on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding here on third and goal. And now here comes the third of their timeouts defensively. So they'll be left with only the 2-minute warning to stop it from here on out. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal.
Dobbins. And Dobbins, he is not going to get there. They stop him short of the line to gain.
Nothing doing on that one, and it'll be fourth down.
So Brady departs, and on is Ryan Succop for the Buccaneer field goal.
This to make it a 3-score game late. Succop's kick is good. And that will extend their lead even further. So with that, you figure this game's pretty much out of reach at this point.
Yeah, it's going to take a heck of a comeback to come from 3 scores down. But don't change that channel. Don't go away. Miracles can happen, and you want to be here in case it does.
You're a company man.
Aren't I, though?
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Their mini 2-game win streak appears it might be going by the wayside unless they can pull a rabbit out of their hat. Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. From the gun, it's Wilson. Flush to his right. He finds his man. Complete. It's Moore. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A big connection on that one. 34 yards. Eluding the pressure right. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. That is caught. It's Anderson. Touchdown, Panthers. Robbie Anderson. His third touchdown now on the year.
And the Panthers have got it back to a 2-score game here in the fourth.
Wilson going to throw for it. Escaping the pressure right.
And the Panthers are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
And the formula there on the 2-point try to go 5 wide. Not even the option to hand the ball off. They got it.
They tried to create space, and there isn't a whole lot of it there. For the defense, what you're trying to do is make sure that someone, if they're going to catch the ball, make them catch it behind you because they run out of space with the back line. But in this case, the offense figured it out.
Thank you. They'll run on first down. Dobbins, and he's taken down inside the 30. Now Dobbins, and he'll work this forward for about 3 at second down.
A 3-yard pickup brings up second and 7.
So time has run out on what will be a Tampa Bay victory. And this coaching staff, CD, I think you'd agree, pleased with this overall effort.
I think they're more than pleased, right? They've got to look at each other like, wow, we just pulled this one off in a big way. Great job of motivating, even better job of game planning. They were facing a top 10 defense, so they had to make sure that everything was buttoned down. And they had it ready to go, and their guys executed.
Yeah, they were concerned not only about moving the ball through the air, but also on the ground. But both really started to come in sync. So for the Buccaneers,
they run their mark to 6-2 on the year.
And they'll head back home next week to take on the Atlanta Falcons. Meanwhile, for the Panthers, they'll fall to 5-3 with a